to load the PDF. So yes, so now things are visible. So can you hear me? Okay, so good afternoon everyone. So today we'll be starting we'll be actually discussing an exciting topic on evolution, so which is important for many competitive exams. And of course, in the YouTube sessions, we haven't talked about evolution, as well as in any of the plus classes, we have not started anything about evolution. Yes, hello, Aranya. So why evolution today? Why we have to talk about evolution? Because, you know, the exams are going to come up. So in 1 hour, I'm just trying to, give the basic ideas. Okay, see, today I won't be talking about genetics. Okay, so today I will be talking about evolution and evidences for different evolution. And in coming classes, yes, I will be continuing some of the chapters. Yes, it is a very big topic. So today only evolution, today only evidences for the evolutions, like how we can say that, yes, something is getting evolved. So those things we are able to know. Adaptations, not today. Okay. Yes. I should have been a little specific, right? Like evidences for evolution, but I was a little in hurry-burry. So in coming classes, that is tomorrow, we'll be discussing about theories. So we know that there are different theories. So, and in coming classes, yes, adaptation as well. So as much as possible, I will be trying to finish off in 3 to 4 days because exams are going to come up. Okay, so as you all know, myself, I'm Vindhya Rao, and I'll be teaching you biology subject in this platform for class 9th and 10th biology, as you all know. And if you want to connect me, so yes, Ansh is already, like, he is in the group. And also he texts me if he has got doubt. So Aranya, are you in the group? Like, have you joined Telegram? Yes. Fine. Let me continue. Okay, you are already there in the Telegram. Great. So if you have got any sort of doubt regarding any of the concept or any of the questions related to NTSC, NSCGS, you can ask me. Okay. Yes. And about the subscription, which is very important for all of you guys. So if you belong to 10th standard and if you feel, yes, you have to take up subscription, please take as soon as possible because already the time is up. But yes, there are certain courses that we haven't started yet. Like for entrance, for competitive exams like NTSC, NSCGS, already the courses are started. But some of the chapters are yet to be covered. So even now you can take the subscription. And if you are the one who feel, no, I know all the concepts of class 9th and 10th, you can directly take up JEE. You can directly take up NEET. So at the same time, you can use our code SCHOOL. So all capital letters. So let me not write in this way. You can use the code SCHOOL to get 10% discount. So how to take the subscription? As you all know, first you have to download an Academy learning app and then go for, yes, download and click on plus option. So when you click on plus option, you are able to see foundation and NTSC, IIT JEE, NEET. So anything you can take up and you can use our code SCHOOL and then click on get subscription if you're going for a foundation and NTSC. So you can see different month subscription, 12 month and 24 month subscription. Yes, I agree. If you look at the subscription amount, you feel it is really huge. But compared to other platform and compared to the coaching centers, it is very, very, very less. And nobody, compels or nobody force you to take up the, their own lecture. You can, yes. Hello, Shreya Rai. So you can take up anyone's classes. Like you can listen to anyone's classes. And it's not that we teach only for, science and mathematics. We also teach here for, yes. Hi, Shreya. So we also teach for, under foundation and NTSC, even for, I can say, social science as well, English as well. And we have got many educators. You can listen to anyone's classes. And we have got monthly quizzes, mega quiz, and also weekly quiz. And the classes are very much, ma'am, light is very dim. Okay, so stay for 1 minute. I will be changing the, yes. How about now? Yes, I'm so sorry. That's why I have asked you at the beginning. Yes, is everything is clear? Okay, so you know about the subscription. Please take the subscription as soon as possible. And yes, you know about our Unacademy learning app. I mean, you know about our the YouTube classes. So please take the subscription. Please subscribe to our channel and like the videos. Keep sharing the videos. Also, you are able to download the PDF. Yes, I agree. Right now, the PDF are not there. So you can ask me through the Telegram app. I'll be sending you the notes of whatever classes we have covered before. Okay, don't worry about the notes. Okay, and yes, you know about different YouTube channel, that is NEET, JEE, along with 9th and 10th foundation. So please subscribe to all the channels and keep liking the videos. Yes, so starting with the evolution. So this is very, very, very important statement of, yes, the scientist Theodosius Dolbensky. Yes, I know the name is quite complicated, but what exactly he told was, nothing in biology makes sense except in the light of evolution. So what does that mean? Like, why exactly he has given? Yes, it is really true. So if we talk about biology, if we do not talk about evolution, biology doesn't make sense, right? Do you agree? Why evolution is important? Because evolution talks about how did we originate and how, what exactly happens to the humankind, mankind. That also is spoken in evolution, how we are originated and how we are connected to different organisms, what is the relationship between. So beautiful sentence, and everyone has to accept this particular, yes, very peacefully, yeah, peaceful word. Nothing in biology makes sense except in the light of evolution. So if nobody talks about evolution, so there is no meaning for biology. We have evolved from different organisms. We have originated. So all of things we talk in evolution. So let's see what are the different causes of evolution. And again, diversity is nothing but how exactly these diverse organisms have been formed, of course, by evolution, right? So all biology in five lines defined. Yes, very true. Yes, you can you can use this as your status as well, right? WhatsApp status, Telegram status. Like, I keep doing that. I'm so sorry for being distracted, but yes, sorry. Okay, so why the cause of diversity is, you know, connected to evolution? Because if you see, we have studied classification in diversity of living organism, archaea, eubacteria, followed by protista, and then fungi, plantae, animal kingdom. So if you see right from archaea, the organisms evolution we are able to see. Yes, Monera. Monera is nothing but eubacteria. Yes, this archaea and eubacteria comes under Monera. So if you see right from archaea till the animal kingdom, you can see a proper line of evolution. Right? So hence the cause of diversity, there are different theories given by different scientists. So coming to the theory of special creation, so which was given by Carolus Linnaeus. So tell me, what was the contribution of Carolus Linnaeus? Because you know diversity in living organism, you have studied in detail, right? So what is the contribution of Carolus Linnaeus or Carl von Linnaeus? So where, Shreya Rai, where are you? Ansh and Aranya, where are you guys? Hierarchy, yes. What are the different hierarchies that he has given? We will be talking, let's not waste our time, right? Yes. So he has developed the classification of the system. Yes, as you told, hierarchy, and very important, his books for different competitive exams. So Systema Naturae is the very first book which was given by him. And second book was Genera Plantarum. And then third book was Species Plantarum. So these are the books which was written by Carolus Linnaeus. So Systema Naturae is the very first book. Remember, his three books are very important. Yes. So he has given the hierarchical, the taxa. So you know, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species was given by him. Okay. So what is the importance of this? Even here you are able to see a sort of evolution here, right? So sorry. Yes. So bacteria, if you see eukarya, archaea is like eukarya has been evolved from archaea, but still you can see a connection link between archaea and eukaryotes. Okay. So why exactly like his, you know, even though he has given certain contribution to taxonomy, so these are nothing but it belongs to taxonomy, right? And also he has given binomial nomenclature, as you all know. What happened? Yes. So also, you know, the binomial nomenclature is given by him. But still, why do we talk about Carolus Linnaeus in evolution? Anybody can guess? Why? What is the main contribution of Carolus Linnaeus in evolution? Yes, anyone? It's here itself. Linnaeus system of Donoma. It's in the slide. Linnaeus system of classification reflects evolutionary relationship. So he basically, he divided, he classified based on the evolutionary relationship. Hence, he has given certain contribution to the evolution. And more importantly, what is he told was, all living things came into existence in their present forms, especially and specifically created by nature. So what he told was, again, it was not completely accepted, but all the theories, whoever has given theories in the evolution, those are important because those are the one which made to think, you know, people about evolution. So again, for the discoveries of different evolution related works was because of, yes, mutation. See, his theory was based on, he told that all the living organisms were created by God. So it is said by different scientists that God created, Linnaeus arranged. Okay, so these are said by other scientists, created by nature. So this is what he speaks about in the theory of special creation. So what is that special creation? So all the organisms are created by nature or God was given by Carolus Linnaeus. Very important. Theory of special creation. And we know about the contribution of Linnaeus for taxonomy. He is called as father of taxonomy and many other titles he has got. So let's not talk about it. And again, I am not talking in detail about these theories. So in coming classes, we'll be talking in detail. Don't worry. So coming to the theory of natural selection. So what does this say? So your Darwinism, your Lamarckism comes under theory of natural selection. You know it, right? So have anybody studied evolution before? Yes, Aryan Tripathi and Ansh. Have you studied? And one more we have. Yeah, Shreya Rai. So tell me, have you? Yes, ma'am, Thoda. So what exactly you have studied? Let's see, what do you know exactly? Like what exactly you have studied? Only genetics, right? Or except that, have you studied anything else in evolution? Okay, heredity. Okay, I have not taken, I will be taking up it in future. Variations. Okay, fine. Doesn't matter. So good that you know a little. Yes. So what does theory of natural selection says? Organisms might evolve through time with one type of organism giving rise to another type of organism. So what does this mean? Theory of natural selection. Organism might evolve through the time with one type of organisms giving rise to another type of organisms. So again, it was given by different scientists. So in the sense, like different scientists talked about theory of natural selection, like Aristotle and Lamarck and Charles Darwin. So what was said by Aristotle? Yes, spontaneous generation. So he said that organisms developed from non-living organism. So he has given some, now we feel it is rubbish. Okay. But yes, at that time, people did not know about evolution. So they were, you know, they thought about it. Acquired character, these things are given by Lamarckism. Laws of inheritance. So spontaneous generation, which was given by Aristotle. So he said that organisms developed from non-living organism. So Aristotle about 2300 years ago argued that air provided a vital life force that could produce life from non-living substance. So he said, if you keep a box with some waste inside, mice or rat will come out of it. Such things are given by him. So later other scientists, they disproved, and there are other, you know, theories as well. So we'll be talking about those in detail in the coming classes. So now just in a gist, I'm talking about some important scientists. So what is their contribution a little? Okay. Yes. And the idea of spontaneous generation prevailed for thousands. And this particular theory, it was there for many years. People believed that, yes, organisms are arised from living organism, was arising from non-living organism. People was thinking, yes, it is true. But other scientists, they disproved it later. Okay. Yes. So coming to the Darwinism. So Darwin has given different theories. So rapid multiplication, limited environmental sources, struggle for existence, variation, survival of the fittest, inheritance of the useful variation. So these things are given by Darwin. So in detail, we'll be talking in the coming classes, not today. Okay, because if you talk about different theories, it will take, you know, more than 1 hour actually. So in coming class, we'll be talking in detail. So this is just a gist about different, you know, theories. Yes, Lamarck's theory of evolution. So what does Lamarck told? Use and disuse theory. Origin of species in his book. Yes, so organism constantly strive to improve themselves by changing. So that's what use and the structure is modified or changed by use or disuse theory. This is very important theory which was given by him. And changes are adaptations to environment acquired in an organism's lifetime. So he also talked about adaptations, like how organisms adapted. And modification is inherited to the offspring. If the organism continuously use particular organ, it can be modified. And such modified, yes, long neck of giraffe. So these things are given by these theories, sentences are given by him. So these are important theories of evolution. So in detail, we'll be understanding. Okay. So coming to what is evolution? So nobody asked me, like even if I was talking about evolution, what is evolution? So it is nothing but transformation or a gradual change that happens in the life. So one more thing, don't get confused that, yes, change according to the environment. So don't get confused that only one organism is getting evolved. So group of organisms, that species, need to show certain changes. Then only we are able to say yes. So these organisms, they got evolved. The species are getting evolved. So if there is change in only one organism, it cannot be called as evolution. So it's a gradual change or transformation in the life on Earth from its earliest form to the vast diversity that we observe it today. So if you see here examples of land, okay, ma'am, why are monkeys stopped evolving? That's what you want to ask me, right? Who said? Are you very sure that monkeys stopped evolving? All organisms are evolving in one or other way, right? So if you see again, It depends on the environment that monkey is present in. So if, okay, I don't know that how many of you are aware of this. If you see crows, hence there has tail. See, tail. First of all, you know that monkeys use tail. So why monkeys need to lose their tail? Okay. So that is one thing. So yeah, I was talking about crows. If you see crows, so in some of the cities, these crows, what they do is they make, you know, nest out of the iron wires. And if you see certain birds like, I can say sparrow, so they show evolution by, you know, changing their food habit depending on the environment. So all the organisms, they evolve depending on the environment that they are in. So if they have to evolve and if there is necessity of evolution, they are evolving, they evolve. Okay. So there is a saying, necessity is the mother of invention. I don't know how many of you have heard this. So if there is necessity, so that's what in the, you know, Lamarckism, he says about disuse and use theory. And again, evolution can be seen in humans as well. As we use our brain more, we will be having, you know, we will show more and more evolution. So as you use your brain more, you are able to solve more and more questions, more and more questions. So you can observe yourself. So if you compare two individuals, like let's say, let's not take your name, somebody else. So Prakash and Akash. So Prakash is using, so I'm giving you an example. Prakash is using his brain. So he is solving more and more questions. He's able to solve if he keep trying or if he keep practicing more and more questions. He's able to solve more and more questions in mathematics, physics or anything. And if you see Akash is not using his brain only. So he won't be able to solve more and more questions. So we can see evolution in ourselves. Right? Do you agree this? Yes, Swapnil. Are we evolving according to the temperature? See, first of all, we are warm-blooded. Okay? So, yeah, actually, yes. According to temperature in the sense, we adapt rather than evolving. See, there is a difference between, yeah, region wise, yes, right. There is a difference between evolution and adaptation. Evolution, see, what is the definition of evolution says? Evolution, we talk about whole species. Adaptation is like among the small group of individuals, we show adaptation, right? So evolution is the transformation, the life on earth from its earliest form to the vast diversity that we observe today. So whole species, if they are able to show changes, then we talk it is an evolution. But if it is in the small groups, we tell as a adaptation. Okay. Yes. And if you see any change in the heritable traits within the population across the generation, so across the generation, we need to be able to see changes. Otherwise, it is not called as evolution, right? Yes. So I hope I have answered all the questions. Yes. So yeah, one of the example of evolution you can see in kingdom plant itself. So mosses, hornworts, liverworts, they are bryophytes. So what are bryophytes? They were non-vascular plants. Yeah, why these changes occur? See, I have told you, necessity. There is necessity. So, okay. Why giraffe elongated or showed the long neck? Because on the land, it did not had any, you know, food. So, they had to feed on the leaves of the tree. So, they had to stretch their neck. And if you see in the case of humans, why you have to use your brain more? Because there is a lot of competition, right? So if you do not use your brain much, you won't be able to solve more questions. you won't be able to crack exams because there is a lot of competitions in the world. So everyone have to study more, right? So do you agree this with me? Like, do you agree whatever I have told till now about evolution? So you can see among yourself. Everything you can see among yourself. Fine? Okay. So yes, example you can say I have told you the bryophytes, they were non-vascular and they were actually, yes. So what are bryophytes? What is the characteristic features of bryophytes? Why bryophytes had to show evolution? So some of the plants, they had to get vascular bundles. Yes, ask questions. Doesn't matter. So if you see in the case of bryophytes, they were living in the damp soil. So you know that certain areas, if you consider in the, okay, logs like differentiated don't have vascular bundles. Yeah, looks like differentiated don't have vascular bundles. Yes, okay. Let me tell you why exactly some of the plants which were living in damp soil had to come to terrestrial environment. Of course, because of the environment changes. All the plants won't be able to, you know, get damp soil. All the plants won't be able to live in the places where there is enough water. So some of the plants, they gained vascular bundles. So they evolved to live in land. Okay, so this is how we are able to see evolution. Yes, so we know what is exactly evolution and why exactly evolution has to occur. So let's see evidences of evolution. Okay, so Anshi is asking, when we touch me not plant, then why it get shrink? Huh? This is an adaptation. So I have given you the reason. I don't remember. Is it in the special class or in the plus class? So first of all, you know how this touch me not plant is present. It's quite weak. Yes, because it loses turgidity. So it is a scientifically. So we have idiom forever. Yes, you are right. But why? Why it has to lose its turgidity? What is the main reason? Adaptation. So basically, when this touch me not plant closes its leaves, when you touch it, how does it appear? It appears as if it is not fresh, as if it has dead. So this is a defense mechanism which is shown by touch me not plant. So to prevent itself from the grazers like herbivores, like cow and cattle, they will be feeding on different herbs and shrubs. So first of all, even these herbivores, they will be feeding on the fresh plants. What mechanism? See, I have told you all these in the control and coordination class. Okay. So it is related with the loss of water from the cells. So when you touch, so there is a chemical signals which will be making the cells to lose, yes, thigmotropism. Yes, when you, actually this is not under thigmotropism idiom forever. This is thigmonasty. Okay, thigmotropism is climbers, which is able to surround around the support. This comes under thigmonasty, okay, nastic movement, yes. So how, okay, let's not go for the control and coordination now. Let's stick on to the topic. So basically, touch me not plant, why exactly it has to close its leaves? Because to show the defense mechanism, so to show itself that it is dead. So that herbivores, they will be mostly preferring to the fresh plants. So when they try to feed on these plants, if they show this closing nature of the leaves, they feel, okay, this is not that fresh, so let's feed on other plants. Okay, yes. So yes, evidences for evolution. So how can we say that the organisms are evolving, especially if you consider the organisms which was there before the existence of humans. Yeah, yes, Ansh. After that, it's not that when this herbivores goes off, it will open. After some time, it will open, because I have told you the cells will gain its turgidity. Okay. Why? Because that is an adaptation. So you know that once the predator comes and once it feels, okay, tell me, do you know the story of bear and two friends? One friend, he will act as if he's dead. And yes, you can relate. Touch me not plant here. Yes, good afternoon. Did you understand, Ansh, now? Did you understand why exactly the plant, touch me not plant, has to open its leaves once again? Okay, fine. So evidences for, okay, I have a lot to talk, fine. Evidences for evolution. So first of all, fossils. So using fossils, we can make out, yes. By seeing different fossils, we can make out, yes, certain organisms are evolving. So you have to know these terms. So why I have put up these terms? Because this can come again for competitive exams. Paleontology. What is paleontology? Ology is always study. Paleo. Paleo is fossils. Okay. So study of fossils are called as paleontology. But what is fossil? So it is a remaining of traces of different organisms that was living long ago. Okay. So again, there are different types of fossils. So one example you can see. So it's not that all the part of organism, I mean, all the part of one organism is able to, you know, remain in stone or amber. I mean, I have given you some of the examples for fossils. So only the hard part. So the if you compare, yes, bone, teeth. Yes, very good. Some of them, it will get converted into fuels as well. Yes. So hence we call fossil fuels natural gas. Okay. Yes. So let's see what are the different types of fossils. So compression fossil. So how exactly this type of fossil might have been formed? Fossil preserved in sedimentary rocks. It's not that an organism go and get preserved into the stone. Yes, it can be possible. So if you consider caves, if an organism, if it goes and lives inside the caves, and if there is either volcanic eruption or if there is a earthquake, if there is an earthquake, if rocks come and hit to this organism, and if it is present between, compressed between the rocks, the organism is able to get fossilized. Okay, again, not all the organism is able to get fossilized, because some of the organism will be completely fed by, I can say, decomposers some of the times, and some of the times the different parts, it might have got lost. You can imagine if a big rock, if it comes and hits you, not you, maybe some other organism, let's consider dog. Its head may go somewhere sometimes, right? But some of the times, a few times, it can get compressed into between the two stones. So only during that time, we are able to see the fossils. And such fossils is called as compression fossils. So you can imagine, it's not that difficult to understand. So with the help of terms itself, we can make out. So coming to the next type of fossils, petrification. So what is petrification? Organic material converted into stone through replacement of original matter with minerals. So what happens is some of the organism, if it is compressed, or if it is present near to the stone, what happens is it can lose its content which is present inside its body. So let's say all the flesh is lost, but that is organic. It's not that organic material is not only skin. Okay, so other part of the body as well. So let's say the flesh. If flesh is lost, it is replaced by certain minerals. So this is one type of fossils in which certain minerals are replacing the organic matter which is present in the body. Okay, it's not only skin. We can consider other part flesh as well. Okay, yes. So coming to the impression, this is very much self-explanatory. Even we can make impression on especially clay soil, right? So dimensional imprint of organism without any organic material left. So no body part, or I can say no flesh or nothing, will be remained on the stone. But you can see impression. You can see the signs of different organ or different body part, especially the footprint. Yes. So this is a type of, one more type of fossils. So coming to the next type, that is cast and molds. So again, the name itself will be able to, you know, we can make out what exactly this type of fossils are. So original bone or shell dissolves away and leaving behind empty space. So what are the different types of molds you can imagine? So this is also type of fossils that we have seen before. So you don't get confused with the fossils that we have already discussed, right? So here, see, impression is different, mold is different. Here, after the organism getting fossilized, the organic matter is lost. Hence, it will show the impression on the rock or the molds. So these are nothing but molds or cast. Usually, again, it is seen on the rocks or soil. Okay. Yes. So very good example here. If you see intact preservation or amber. So if you see the certain trees, they are able to produce resins, right? The sap, if you cut the small part of the tree. So this resin, they will be able to trap certain organism. In impression, the organism will go on leaving its footprint. See, first of all, let me tell you, these classification is given by us. Okay. So if we are able to see certain type of fossil in which we are able to see just empty spaces. I mean, if you consider, I have given you example of, yes, this one. So here, there is no organic matter is remained. It's not that it is lost. Organism was alive. So it was able to make a sign or impression. And this is how impression type of fossils have been formed. So I know you're getting confused with, yes, he or she walked on this rock. It's not that the organic matter is lost by the certain environmental calamities. But here, if you see, in the case of, you know, molds or cast, here the organic matter is lost by certain environmental changes. Yes, you have got it. So this is very beautiful example. So this, certain people, they keep this as showpiece as well. When resin is able to trap the organism, again, it is able to show fossilized form. Yes. So oozing tree sap traps insect and other organism. Of course, the large organisms won't be able to get entrapped into the resins. Okay. But small organisms like insects, and I can say, yes, usually arthropods, they're able to get entrapped into the amber, that is into the resins. So these are different types of fossils, but how exactly we are able to determine, yes, this particular organism is of 1,000 years old. How exactly we are able to make out? Yes, anybody? Because some of you have told me that, what about mollusca? Mollusca you have seen here. Mollusca will have shells. So shells are able to show fossils in the form of molds or cast. Okay, because you know mollusca, they have got soft body, so usually, yes, only shells are able to seen usually. Okay, and some of the time it may can get entrapped into the amber, but no, not it's very rarely that can happen. Why organism is not? Okay, because mollusca, they have got very soft body. So usually organic matter, you know, the fleshy body is lost. Because fleshy body is rotten or it is decomposed by decomposers. What about slug? Who doesn't have shells? So there are other possibilities. Maybe petrifications can also be done. Octopus. Okay, I'm not very sure how can octopus can be fossilized. What is happening with the octopus? See, octopus, they are the marine or they live in water, right? So again, if you see in the case of these organisms, they are able to get petrified. And if you see here, formation of molds and cast. These usually occur. Are they converted into petroleum? Yeah, they can convert. See, anything, any fossils can be converted into petroleum. Okay. And I can't specifically tell you how octopus exactly can get fossilized, how slug exactly can get, fossilized. So these are different types of fossil formation. So that's what I can tell you in general. And if you want me how humans are able to get fast fossilized, I have to make separate class and I have to study a little more about each and every organism, how these can get fossilized. Okay. Yes. So yeah, here I didn't actually get question. I didn't get answer for my question. I had asked you how exactly we are able to determine what is the age of these fossils. So that is by the carbon dating usually. Yes, ma'am. Why human bone is not mixed with the soil? See, it will mix with the soil, but it will take some time. Okay. Yes, carbon dating method. Yes, because of its hard matrix. Correct. But again, it is able to, get mixed up, but it will take long time. If you see in the case of, I guess you have heard about plague, right? So during after the plague, the humans, whoever have dead by plagues, they used to bury these, humans in one particular place. And even now, some of the skeleton are available, which are of some 100 years. But maybe after 1,000 years, we won't be able to get the entire intact skeletal system because it is lost by, it can get mixed with the soil, right? Yes. So what is this carbon dating? Anybody can tell me? Of course, you should know this because most of you are chemistry students, so you know about half-life. So using the half-life of carbon, which are usually present in the fossils, because you know that all the organisms are made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Yes, in carbon dating, MTD ratio of C12 to 14 is considered radioactive. dating as well. So you know how exactly we are able to determine. Yes. So Tripti, in which class are you studying? I guess I have got a lot of 12th standard students as well, because 9th and 10th standard students. Okay, 10th, great. So I have not seen in the class. I have not seen you in the class. Good. So you know different things. Uranium and lead, yes. So let's not talk, because you already know how exactly carbon dating is done. Yes. So other type of, you know, evidences for evolution is anatomy. So under comparative anatomy, we are able to see different types of structures like vestigial organs, homologous structures, analogous structures. So do you know about these different structures? You are having Maharashtra board. Okay. So is it? Yes, you know everything. Fine. So you belong to 9th or 10th, but like, did you study on your own, or you had these in your classes? Because evolution usually, if you see your, okay, self-study, great. Tuition on our own. Yes, good. So whoever have done on your own, you're really great, because I know now, like usually since you had a midterm exam, say in your midterm exam, you will be having the beginning chapters, right? So evolution comes later. So this is why I got it out. Yes. So coming to comparative anatomy, yes, homologous structure. So what does homologous structures mean? Structures that have a common origin but may be used for different things. So usually students get confused with homologous and analogous. Okay. So yes, what is analogous? You know what is homologous structures now. I mean, you already knew this, right? So what is analogous structure? So first of all, how can you remember that structures that have a common origin? Structures that have a common origin are homologous structure. Homo. Homo means same. Okay. Logos. What is logos? Logos is location, or again, if you see in the case of genetics as well, we have seen a word logos. Logos was bat, bird, are, yeah, these are the example. So homologous structures, homo means same. So same origin organisms are called as homologous structure. But what is different in this organism? Even though they have originated from this common origin, because of their different environmental condition, because of their necessity for different functions, they had to evolve. So they show different structures. Okay. So structures that have a common origin but may be used for different things are an example. Yes, if you see the limbs of bird and humans, whale, dog, they are originated from a common origin, but functions are different. So why functions was different? Because of their different environmental condition, because of their different necessity to do different functions. Okay. So example, you know, coming to, yes, convergent evolution, similar structure due to similar environmental pressures. Embryological evidence, paleontological evidence. So you know these things. I didn't expect that you would have known these things. So I guess in coming class, directly we can go for questions, right? No need of, you know, talking more about evolution. We can directly. Okay. So fine. Next time, I mean, in next classes, I won't be taking up the classes for evolution. Directly questions will be answering. Fine. So convergent evolution, as Ansh was also telling me, nothing but analogous evolution. So what does analogous evolution says? Ma'am, keep next class for class 9th as well. Okay, so tell me. Okay, today itself I will be solving questions on diversity in living organisms, Swapnil. Okay, so that is for class 9th. And if you want me to take up any chapters as a revision I can take up, but please let me know once. Okay, yes. So convergent evolution is analogous type of evolution or anatomy. What does the structures in the analogous structures can be seen? Homologous, same origin, different function. Analogous, different origin, same function, same structures. Yeah. So can anybody give me example for analogous evolution or analogous structures which comes under convergent evolution? BAT. What do BAT do? What does BAT do? Eagle. So these are birds. Give me example specifically. Yes, if you see the wings of different organisms, bat, eagle, yes, butterfly. So these have got, the structures have got different origin, but function is for flying. Yes. So analogous is convergent evolution. Homologous structures is divergent evolution. So why convergent and divergent? Is this convergent or divergent? Is divergent or is this particular figure? So if you see convergent, divergent, these terms comes under physics, right? Image formation. So same thing if you try drawing about the evolution, same thing we can apply here as well. Like if you see, as you know, how exactly the convergent, divergent images are formed in physics about lens, eyes, you will be studying, right? So same thing here also we are able to see above, please. East owl is also analogous. Wings. Yeah. It's not that. See, when we are talking about homologous structures and divergent evolution, it's not that we are taking up only one organism. We are taking a set of organism and comparing, because see, comparative anatomy, this is a type of evidence in which using the different anatomy of different organisms, we are able to make out, yes, these are homologous structures. Okay. So if you see the wings of owls, they can also show, we can also talk about homologous structures over there. We are also able to talk about divergent evolution there. And also we are able to talk homologous structures there. We are also able to talk about convergent evolution there. How? Here if you see bird. See Archaeopteryx. Okay, Archaeopteryx also. But Archaeopteryx is a connecting link between reptiles and birds. Okay. So let's not get confused much. Because Archaeopteryx, if you see, they have got wings. At the same time, they have got claws, scaly claws. So they show certain characters of reptiles as well, certain characters of birds as well. Okay. So this belongs to divergent evolution because common origin, different function, convergent evolution. How is convergent evolution? Homologous structures, convergent. How exactly you draw convergent? If this is divergent, this is, yes. So I'm so sorry, I'm really bad in drawing. That's what, yeah, Ansh, that's what I told you. Archaeopteryx. Archaeopteryx is a connecting link. I have taught connecting link for NEET. So I hope even you were there for the class. Modern birds do not have teeth. So birds do not have teeth. But Archaeopteryx, they are able to show both the characters of reptiles and birds. Hence, we call them as a connecting link between reptiles and birds, apes. So what is this connecting link? They were trying to evolve from reptiles to birds. So this is an exception. Yes, it is an exception. Okay. Yes. So coming to next type of evidences, that is biochemical evidences. So everybody knows what is biochemical evidence. Yes, is everybody is with me? Okay, let me continue. Brief, ma'am. Okay. So you know what is genetic code? How exactly genetic code is formed? Right? AUG. Yes. So how exactly biochemical genetic code belongs to biochemical evidences? Because we know that all the codes, so let's say not all exactly, but most of the codes, if you see AUG, AUG is the start codon. It is able to give rise to formyl methionine or methionine. So this is universal in all the organism. And if you see most of the codons or codes, if you see, they are able to produce same amino acid in most of the organisms. So hence, so when I tell organism, it is right from archae till the animal kingdom. So most of the codes are able to give rise to same amino acids. So I won't be telling what are codes, codons, as you all know it. They're able to give rise to same amino acids. So this particular thing will able to think us, yes. Since all these features are present in all the organism. So there is connection between all these organisms. So triplets of DNA nitrogenous bases sequence that code for a specific amino acid, and amino acid triplet is the same in almost all the organism. And all the organisms are made up of nitrogenous bases. All the organisms are made up of nucleotides. So in all the organisms, we are able to see a common thing. Yes, central dogma, replication, transcription, protein synthesis. This is common if you see right from bacteria till animal kingdom, all the organisms are able to show. So this will make out, this we can use to say that yes, these all are connected. So hence evolution was seen from the lowest to the highest organisms. So probable common ancestor for all life on earth. So coming to the next type, that is yes, RNA, rRNA, mRNA, tRNA, these also we are able to see in all the organisms. Nucleotides are same. Proteins, carbohydrates can be seen in all the organisms, right? So coming to the next type of comparative anatomy, vestigial structures. So what are the different vestigial structures which are present in, which is present in our body? Appendix. Yes, yes. Coccoix, yes. Human tail bone, coccyx, appendix. What was the importance of appendix? Very good. Ear pinnae. What is the importance of appendix? Using this appendix, we were able to digest cellulose, right? Let's say in the Stone Ages, humans were feeding on certain leaves, plants as well, along with the meat, right? So beginning, we started with feeding on to the plants. So we know that plants has got cellulose, and the cellulose need to get digested. How exactly cellulose can get digested? With the help of appendix. But now we eat cooked food. We went for, like we started opting for cooked food. So there is no need of digesting cellulose because we started decreasing having, feeding directly onto the plants. So coming to even nictitating membrane. We had nictitating membrane, but we have lost now because there is no importance of nictitating membrane. Wisdom teeth also. So you know about all these things. There is no need of talking much. Yes. Coming to embryological evidence. So if you see the embryo of all the organisms, if you consider vertebrates, all the vertebrates have got same embryonic structures, right? There is no much difference. These are the adult, I mean, these are the last stages of embryo of different organism. But if you see early embryonic stages, all have got same structures. So this also shows that, yes, we have evolved from one another. So it's like a blueprint. Yes. Huh. Even DNA, if you see, we all have got deoxyribonucleic acid. So deoxyribonucleic acid is made up of phosphate, deoxyribose, and sugar. And sugar also, ribose, sugar, sorry, deoxyribose only. There is no other sugar which is involved in the genetic material. Phosphate and nitrogenous bases also. All the four nitrogenous bases are same in all the organisms. So this shows that we have evolved from one another. Coming to observable events. So this we'll be talking further in the coming class whenever we are talking about the theories. So Darwin finches. Do you know about Darwin finches? Do you know about peppered moth color shifts? These are explained in detail in the 11th and 12th class. Okay, what exactly you do not know, Tripti? Yes, Industrial Revolution. So that is about, so you know about, it's a simple story, nothing else. And Darwin finches. If you see, Darwin finches is nothing but Darwin has gone to, like he had gone to Galapagos Island and he had observed different types of birds which had different beaks depending on their food habit. They had adapted. So that was observable events which was seen by Darwin. So he told that organisms were, especially birds, the finches, they were evolving depending on their food habits. Okay, so it's very simple, it's a story. Yes, so in coming classes we'll be understanding the different theories of different scientists and we'll be understanding better about evolution. So this was just evidences and introduction for evolution. So do you want me to talk further about the scientist or let's directly go to the questions in the coming class? Okay, so Swapnil is telling me questions, fine. So Swapnil, yes, along with hard and soft beak, the shapes of the beaks were also different. Okay, yes, so fine. So Tripti want me to directly go for the questions. So let's do one thing. In tomorrow's class, directly we will go for the questions. And depending on your answer, I'll be able to make out how much you know. Okay. Yes, I hope the class was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. So let's meet in the coming class. That is today. Again, I'll be taking class. So we'll be discussing questions of diversity in living organism. Tomorrow's class. Okay, I will be keeping on the same time. 1:30 to 2:30. Fine. Okay, so thank you so much. If you have got questions, you can always ask me in the Telegram app. So bye bye. Please give me the feedback as well. Bye bye.